A lot of people have this misconception that you probably need like an almighty setup to film your first video on YouTube or to probably start your channel. But take it or leave it from me, you need the most minimal equipment when you're just starting out, especially when you're on a strict budget or you do not have a lot of cash to splurge on. So if you fall in either of these two categories, then you definitely want to keep on watching, because I am going to be sharing with you tips and the equipment that you would need to get started. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Should you be seeing me for the first time, my name is Adishola. If you're seeing me for the second time or the third time on your screen, thank you very much for coming back to watch this video. It means a lot to me. And if you're yet to subscribe to my channel, please do not forget to do that by clicking on the subscribe button down below and also the notification bell beside it so you don't miss out on any of my uploads. I'm going to be sharing with you the basic equipment you need to start your own YouTube channel. So the first equipment you'll be needing to start your channel is a recording device. And what I mean by a recording device is a camera, basically something that you can see yourself in, you can express yourself, and people can know, okay, this is this person talking, this is what this person is doing, and can show the basic things you are trying to show your audience, right? In terms of camera, it could be a DSLR camera or the camera from your mobile phone. So when starting out, I want to believe you are limited to your options and you probably don't have a DSLR camera. The option and the best alternative for you would be to go with your mobile phone. Whichever phone you have would just do the job, trust me. The most affordable and the most common equipment you can probably use is your mobile phone. If you're watching this video, you probably have a mobile phone, right? So that is like a great way to start. Using your mobile phone is like the most affordable, the most budget-friendly device you can ever use to start your channel. And most mobile phones right now currently film in like high resolutions. I'm very sure with iPhone, they film iPhone, at least iPhone 7 Plus films in 4K 60 frames per second, 4K 30 frames per second. iPhone 8 Plus also do that. I currently use an iPhone 8 Plus. I am not filming with an iPhone 8 Plus, right? But my iPhone 8 Plus has like a 4K resolution with 60 frames per second and 30 frames per second. My sister's iPhone, she uses an iPhone 7 Plus, also shoots in that great quality. I'm sure some other phones can also shoot in amazing quality. Samsung can do a very good job with that. As I don't know their recording resolutions, but I feel like they should be able to do an amazing job as well. If you have other phones, just make sure you check your camera settings and put it on the highest resolution, because I didn't even notice there's like a 4K filming resolution on my phone until recently. I was trying to explain something to a friend of mine and I came across it. Boom. So if you don't check, you are not going to know. So check your camera settings and make sure it is on the highest resolution. It could be on HD. My phone used to film in like 180 HD, 24-25 frames per second, which was also an amazing quality, right? I actually did film a YouTube video on my iPhone 8 Plus back then, but then I was still very new to YouTube. Like, I just wanted to start my YouTube channel. When I posted it, I received like a mail or something telling me that my channel is going to be banned because I use like a copyrighted music. I was like, oh, I'm just starting out and you want to ban me? So I just removed the video and I didn't bother posting it. But the quality of the video I shot back then was really amazing. That was just last year, actually. It was really amazing. And trust me, it is a very good way to go with. Now that we are done with the phone, let's move on to the second equipment you'll be needing. The second equipment you'll be needing to start your YouTube channel or to film a YouTube video is going to be a light source. You don't want to be filming a YouTube video or any video at all and your audience would not be able to see what you are doing. Imagine if everywhere is just dark like this, you'll be like, what is this person even saying? You won't be interested in whatever content I'm putting out there, right? So you want to make sure you have a very good light source, which is very, very important. It is just as important as your recording device. So if you're looking at starting your channel with the most affordable, the best light, or the best light you can actually use when you're starting out is sunlight, like the natural light kind of. But one thing about natural light is that it is not stable. Imagine I am currently filming, this is 2 minutes to 7. Imagine if I'm going to be using my natural light, it is not going to be working for me by this time of the day. So now I am currently filming with an artificial light. But your natural light is like a great way to start. Just that you would need to have like a timing for it, because you know, you like, you're probably going to sit outside and start waiting for when the sun is going to come out or when it's going to really clear outside and not cloudy. You don't want to film videos when the light is not really good. It's not going to come out well, trust me. So you want to make sure you have like the best light source. So an alternative to natural light is a ring light. I'm sure most of us are familiar with what a ring light is. I'm going to put it up here in case you don't know, but I'm sure you do know. I currently have like a ring light in front of me, which is what I'm filming with, and I have two other sources of lights right here beside me. But if you have a ring light, then that is going to also do an amazing job. A ring light is, I started filming with a ring light. When I started posting content on Instagram, before my account got deactivated, I was using my ring light and my phone. In fact, back then I do use my front camera because I always wanted to see what I'm doing. I don't want to be filming and then I notice after filming for maybe an hour or two, I've been filming like, I've not been in frame and I'm probably like this inside my video, you get. I want to make sure I'm right in the center of the frame. So I do film with my front camera, which gave me a decent amount of quality. It was not bad. Instagram back then was still like, doesn't really reduce quality. Whatever you put out there is what people get to see, compared to now that even if you put like 100 MB video, it's going to take it down to like maybe 50 or so. But filming with the front camera was like the deal for me. But now that you're filming for a video, a YouTube video, or even Instagram content right now, you do not want to use your front camera. The best thing to use is your back camera. So what you do with your phone and your ring light is that you place your phone on, there's usually like this phone clip that comes with ring light. If it doesn't come with yours, you probably have to buy it to mount it to your ring light. I'm going to show you what that looks like in a bit so you can understand what I'm talking about.
So this is what the ring light usually comes with. It comes with stuff like this. You can just remove it and screw it here as well. Just screw it. Can you see? And you're just going to place it like this. And boom. You're going to feel. There's a screw that's supposed to be here. I already misplaced it and I saw it lying somewhere in, but all you need to do is just make sure it's like this and then you can start filming. Can you see how easy this is? Just sit right in front of it and film.
And when you put it right in the center of your ring light, it's going to show you like you're going to be in frame, because you're looking at the ring light, you're looking into the lens. You just have to position your world, just have to check and you know that okay, I'm in frame. And by the time you start getting used to that, you would be sure of where to be when you're filming and know that if I put my head like this or like this, then I'm going to be in frame, right? You don't want to just cut yourself out or your head is starting from here while I'm seeing the whole of your body. No, we don't want that. So light, your ring light is like the second most important. It's just as important as your mobile phone. Those are like the two most important things you really need to start your channel. If you don't have the sunlight option, like I said, then the ring light is a good way to start with as well. And it's so far it's, you turn it on, you're going to get a decent amount of light. It actually has like, some ring light comes in like 3,000, 2K to 5,005. Moves from cold tone light to like the white light, which is really good. You can change the temperature and, you know, adjust it anyhow you want and then you'll be fine. Just make sure you check your camera settings and you are filming in the highest possible resolution you can film. The resolution, please film in HD. Don't film in something lesser than HD. If you can see 4K, in fact, 4K qualities are the best. 4K video quality are actually like the best. If you upload a video on YouTube using a 4K resolution, you are a boss. So if you have a phone that can do that amount of job for you, you are good to go. You really don't have anything that is stopping you from starting your channel. In addition to your ring light and your phone, I'm going to be sharing with you again other stuff you can add to make your filming easier. one of the things you need to make your filming easier is having like a tripod instead of your ring lights, phone clip. Okay, what I was talking about, the phone clip is this stuff right here. Okay, I'm trying to, oops. Is this stuff? It actually comes with most tripods you buy. This stuff right here, it actually comes with most tripods and it comes with ring light. At least ring light I bought, it did came with it, which is a good one. But if you're looking out for stuff that can actually make your job easier, is getting a tripod. I have about three types of tripods. Like, I think what I have the most in this my house is tripods. I have like different types of them because there are some that can, this one has like a remote, because this can work as a selfie stick as well. Can you see that? So I can just, maybe I want to vlog, I can just put my phone and just hold it like this and then it's like, hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All right, yeah, but this cannot actually really do that job because I have to, it's much longer and, you know, so if you want to film and make your job easier, I think another good way to start off with is a tripod. This tripod is just about 6,000 naira in Nigeria, and that's equivalent to maybe $20. Dollars is not very expensive, say like $15 right now. So that's like a very good one to start. It comes with this phone holder you can use to attach to your phone and make your job easier. If you don't have the luxury of buying tripods, let me tell you what you can use. Can you see? You can actually use stuff like this. Is like a packaging box for one mirror light, one LED light I actually got. So you can use this stuff. Imagine if you have, I have about two of this stuff and I just placed it on a chair. I put it on a chair, I placed my laptop on it so I can like see myself while filming. Do you get? So if you have like two or three, it doesn't have to be this thing, but you need a box that is quite rigid. Do you get that? When you put it, you place it on a table, you place your phone on it, this is going to work. There's a way you can place this packaging box on the table and put your phone on it to make it actually work while you have your ring light on it. Even if you're just filming with your sunlight, you can just place it on a table, put your phone on it. You just have to know your angles right, put your phone on it, and then you're filming. So this is also a great alternative to tripods if you can't afford to buy one right now, which it's not a big deal, but I'm just going to show you what I would do normally. I'm just going to place this on like maybe a chair. Can you see? Let me raise up. Can you see? This is my chair. So I'm just going to place it on it like that. And I'm probably just going to fix my phone without the tripod. Since I don't have an option of tripod right now, I'm just going to place my phone right in front of it. I'm just going to place my phone right in front of it like this. Can you see? And I'm going to be filming with my back camera. It just depends on how you can place your phone and how you are very good with positioning and angle and your angles, right? That is what is going to determine how good the video, the stability and everything is going to come out. Like, you get that, like my one trick or my one tip for you. Then the other thing you need is like a great audio device, right? Because when filming with your phone tends to pick up a whole lot of noise. One of the reasons why I do not like filming with my phone, or most times when I film with phone, I tend to always use like, do like a voiceover, which I don't enjoy because I have to pause, I have to watch what I'm doing. Then now start saying, oh, I'm applying eyeshadow, yeah, I'm putting red lipstick, when I can just sit down and have like a talk through video like instead of having to do a voiceover. But because we are just starting out, we don't have most of those items. You can just record with your phone, but make sure you are recording where there is a limited amount of noise. Like, you don't want to record when people are crying beside your house, because right now I have someone screaming beside my house right now, like while I'm filming. So imagine if I'm using my iPhone to film, my iPhone is going to pick up that noise. My iPhone picks up noises from like, I don't want to exaggerate, but it picks up a whole lot of noise, which is one of the things I really don't like about it. So if you can afford to get like a microphone, I would suggest you get this kind of microphone that I'm using. It is a lapel mic or something. I can't find the pack close to me. It is called like a lapel mic. You just have to connect it to your phone or your camera, whatever it is you're using, and you can record. And the audio quality is really great. I just started using this recently. Like, this is the first video I'm filming with it, right? But I've tested it over time, compared it with my iPhone's audio, then my camera audio, to compare and see which one of it gives me like the best results, right? So if you can go for this lapel mic, then I feel like you're going to get a decent amount of audio when filming your content, right? So I think I've covered your phone, the accessory, phone accessory, light, microphone, tripod, which I think they are just the basic thing you need to start a YouTube channel. Lastly, what I'm going to add when filming your YouTube video is that you need a very good background. You don't want to be filming when somebody is passing behind you, do you? No. So you want to make sure you have like a very good background. Maybe instead of having something like this, you can just have like, you can just film in front of your wall. Like, you face the wall and you just film, which is good. Whichever wall you have would do the job. It could be any color, but if you have like a white wall in your house, then I think that is a great way to start. Because white wall, there's a thing with white walls that helps with light. It kind of bounces the light, and it just makes a very huge difference when you're filming in a white background setup, kind of, if you understand what I'm saying. Yeah, so if you have an alternative of that compared to filming with anyhow background, maybe, you know, you understand what I'm saying. Yeah, so just go for like a white wall in your arms or anything. And if you cannot use a white wall, you can just look for like a white backdrop, a white cloth, and just find a way to hang it around, just like make hooks or something. You just hang it and you just put a white background, then you're good to go. So that's just everything you need to start your YouTube channel. I want to believe that I've tried to cover like most of the equipment you need to start your YouTube channel. It's not more than this. So it just depends on how fast you want to upgrade. Like, okay, I don't want to use my phone again, I want to go for a camera, then you're now left with, what camera do I want to buy? I don't want to use just my ring light. Okay, what other lighting source do I want to add? Okay, then I don't want to use my wall, I want to use like a backdrop stand and a white backdrop, or I want to use something else. You get it? But when starting out, you can just start with stuff that you can basically find in your house. You get to, I don't think it is actually beyond that when starting out. Just start. The thing is that just start. I wish I had started YouTube like a very long time ago. You know, it would have made a lot of sense to me. But I was thinking, oh, I need to get 10 million likes. I need to get this. I need to get that. So I did not actually start until I got the kind of stuff I needed for me to start off, right? But thinking about it, like, thinking back, I was like, okay, I should have done this, I should have done that. You get, so I feel like, so I think this video is going to be helpful to at least one or two people out there who has been wanting to start their YouTube channel but doesn't know how to go about it. Thinking they need like an almighty lighting setup or almighty background or almighty camera from somewhere. But trust me, you just have to start from somewhere. The thing about it is that you just need to start. Babe, you just need to start. When you start, then every other thing can come in place. Like, okay, do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. So if you find this video very helpful, please subscribe. Please give this video a thumbs up. And please share this video with your friends that might find this helpful, that might need this or something. Don't be stingy to them. This is free. So please, so support this channel by subscribing and by giving this video a thumbs up. Thank you very much for taking your time to watch this video. I hope you do enjoy this video. I hope you do so. So thank you. I keep saying thank you. Thank you very much. And I'm going to see my next one. Bye.